the most important castle in the region, but it did not always look the way it does nowadays. Traces of its past reveal how the castle has been transformed and extended, offering an idea of how Vianden might have looked in earlier times. In 2015, a drone surveyed the castle with the help of modern laser technology. It documented the castle and its surroundings to the millimeter, using millions of measurements. Combining the measurements with data gathered during the previous 10 years, a computer-generated 3D model of the buildings was created. Scientists supplement the model with the findings of archaeological and historical research, and thus bring to life the castle's development over the centuries. The castle's construction and modifications were studied as early as the 19th century. Archaeological excavations, however, first began in the 1970s. During these excavations, a number of different layers emerged, containing shards, rubble, fire marks, remains of waste pits, wooden posts, walls, and foundations. These deposits, formed over many centuries, correspond to different epochs and phases of the castle's construction. The architectural history of Vianden's rocky plateau stretches over 1,600 years. In the late Roman period, around 400 AD, a fortified sentry post stood here. It was probably intended to secure a river crossing and a road to the city of Trier. This high rock, with its steep sides, towered above the River Ourthe and offered excellent protection against attacks, a necessary defense as the Roman Empire at that time regularly experienced raids and invasions by Germanic tribes. A range of ceramic shards and metal coins were essential for dating this phase of construction. Although only a few pieces of the late Roman buildings were found, archaeologists nevertheless managed to reconstruct their floor plan. The masonry of today's castle still contains pieces of a large tower from this time. The shallower side of the rock was protected by a wide ditch. The ditch was built over a few centuries later, but it can still be seen today in the cellar of the castle. Additional stone and wooden buildings can only be reimagined on the basis of a few excavated remains. After the disintegration of the Roman Empire, the old sentry post lay unused for around 300 years, and there are no documents or traces that reveal what happened during this time. The next confirmed findings date from the time between 700 and 800 AD. During this time, archaeologists assume that the late Roman stone tower, as well as some of the wooden buildings, were rebuilt and used. About 200 years later, circa 1000 AD, a castle appeared for the first time on the rocky plateau. At that time, Vianden Castle was divided into two distinct sections, the main castle and the bailey. the main castle was surrounded by a meticulously constructed brick wall, exactly 1 meter thick. Within this ring wall stood a hall. Here, the Count received guests and administered the law on behalf of the king. A chapel was built within the remaining parts of the Roman tower. The entrance to the main castle sat above a nearly vertical rock, which was probably reached by wooden stairs. The original doorway has been preserved to this day. The second section of the castle, the bailey, was at the time protected by palisades. Historical documents from around 1090 identify Count Berthold as the owner of Vianden. He probably moved his residence here. Over the following century, his descendants built the castle into the centre of their county. Written sources suggest that, from then on, noble families inhabited the castle uninterruptedly for hundreds of years, and architectural evidence lends further support to this. The Count's family lived in a new, large stone tower constructed within the main castle. At this point, Vianden possessed the three principal components of a medieval aristocratic castle: a tower, a hall, and a chapel. The bailey contained the gatehouse and other stone outbuildings, which were probably used as storage facilities, stables, and workshops. In the 12th century, the Counts of Vianden expanded their territory and increased their political importance. In this period, the castle was extended several times. Residential tower was greatly enlarged. The Great Hall was redesigned as a bright and open space with Romanesque double windows. The chapel was completely renovated with a 10-sided design. Connected by a circular wall walk, which required moving the ring wall farther away. The new wall was 5 meters thick in some places and set on top of high arches.
5 meters.
The constructions from this period were able to be dated by analysing wooden remains, such as the remnants of scaffolding, using a common technique called dendrochronology. Dendrochronology is the technical term when a new ring is created. Climatic conditions influence the shape and width of these annual rings, but they are similar in the construction works, the appearance of the castle changed once more. The castle was extended across nearly the entire plateau. Buildings such as the old hall were demolished or integrated into other structures, while further buildings were added. A 3-story great hall was built, measuring 30 meters long and 10 meters wide. It became the place where the Count administered the law and held court. Between the great hall and the chapel, a gallery was built, its large openings topped with trefoil arches. The chapel itself was magnificently expanded. The upper story was reserved for the noble family. Inside the bailey, an octagonal tower was built around 1200. Its foundations are still visible today. The tower is located on a central axis which runs through the newly designed buildings, the Great Hall, the gallery, and the chapel, and is turned towards the settlement. During this period, the town of Vianden began to flourish. Between 1250 and 1300, another change took place. The castle was renovated in Gothic style. Particularly impressive features of this period include the elevated attic stories, as well as the Gothic vaults inside the main castle. After these extensive constructions, the only notable changes in the following centuries took place in the bailey. The entryway to the castle was moved to the northwest side, where it is still located today. This new access was intended to impress visitors, and it also offered more protection against intruders than the old gatehouse, as it was reinforced with two additional gates. Together, the new gates formed a bottleneck, which was particularly easy to defend. Around 1400, all the structures in the bailey, including the octagonal tower, were demolished in order to make room for new outbuildings. To this point, what we know about the appearance of a castle is based on architectural and archaeological research. But in the 17th century, we find a visual representation of the castle for the first time, a copper engraving by Matthias Merriam from the year 1643. At that time, the castle was used as a repository and residence by the count's administrators. As the count's family was no longer living at the castle, the imposing architecture was relegated to more mundane uses. In 1820, the King of the Netherlands, who then owned the castle, sold it to a resident from Vianden. The castle was subsequently used as a quarry and finally fell into ruin. During the Romantic period, the ruins became a popular destination for locals and tourists, as well as an object of research for architectural historians. In 1977, the ruin finally came into the possession of the Luxembourg state, which decided to rebuild the castle in the Gothic style of around 1300. During the reconstruction works, Archaeological excavations were carried out alongside documentation of the existing structures and a historical analysis of the site. Today, the Castle of Vianden is by far the most popular attraction in Luxembourg, welcoming more than 200,000 visitors each year. With its astonishing size and history stretching back more than 1,000 years, many Luxembourgers see the castle as a symbol of their historic prominence and significance.